Welcome back, everyone. We've just learned that the Red Cross will open up a shelter at the First Baptist Church in Atoka after a deadly tornado caused a lot of damage there.
And the area that's really been hit hard is the Tushka area, and that's where Eyewitness News 5's Jessica Holloway is. And Jessica, you are down there, and you are just surrounded by all kinds of rescues and ambulances and everyone trying to help.
Yeah, Paul, take a look at this. This truck across the street has come to repair this power line that's across this road. This is 69 headed southbound as this truck comes across. It's kind of been causing an issue. They didn't want this to get in anybody's tires to cause any kind of damage. So they are here. They're going to try to get that cleared off this roadway. And in the meantime, we are standing with two people who were traveling through this area, a sister and her friend who actually came from Plano to rescue her. This is Carrie. Thank you so much for being with us. And tell us what happened tonight.
Well, I was just driving through and hadn't heard anything. And then all of a sudden I saw all the stuff blowing down the street. And so I just pulled over to this gas station. And by then it was too late to get out of my car. So I just ducked down underneath my steering wheel. And then my windows blew out. And luckily that was about the worst that happened. So afterwards, then there was people that had been in the freezer, I guess, or the storage area in the gas station. And so they came out.
So I'm sorry, this is Kelly and this is your sister Carrie, and I see you have the duct tape in your hands. So tell us, you came up from Plano to help your sister.
Right, yeah. My husband and I, when she called and told us what happened, we just jumped in the car and drove up here, and with the duct tape and some towels and a change of clothes, you know, we weren't sure what we would find, but hopefully we'll be able to put things together so we can get her vehicle to Dallas where it can be.
And right now, you know, that road has got all the trees down, you said. Can you kind of tell us what you saw on 69?
Well, we did see some branches and trees more on the side of the road, but we saw several overturned 18-wheelers, and we could smell the fuel, you know, that was leaking from them. That was pretty scary. And then the electrical power lines across the road, things like that. So,
wow.
Yeah, it kind of looked like a war zone.
Well, luckily you guys are safe tonight and together, and we're going to hope you well, wishing you well.
Thank you,
guys. Thank y'all so much. Thanks. Good luck to you.
Thanks.
And if you want to take a look across the street, this is growing, this area. These emergency vehicles, they've started with about 5 when we got here an hour ago, but they've grown to about 50, and they're so busy right now they can't talk to us because they have to drop what they're doing and go and run emergency calls. When people need help at their homes, they go and they try to rescue them, get them out, evacuate them. Like you said, that shelter's now open. They want to get people to safe places so that if we experience any more inclement weather, they're in a position to be safe tonight.